So finally, I'll be discussing about if we have the dynamic loading already obtained from wind tunnel test, how we can use those loading to apply in our ETABS model if the model is available. So this part I'll be focusing on ETABS specifically and how we can induce or apply actually import the dynamic loads, wind loads for the dynamic analysis of our model against wind. So actually I'll be talking about design wind information, axis system, point load calculation, base moment and point load coefficients. These slides again I repeat that they are from Mr. Kanin from AIT Solutions. So the design wind information is mostly available from consultant and they are also prescribed in building codes. For example, one example set of information about design wind speed is here that if you go for IBC 2009 building code in this particular example, it prescribes the mean return period 50 years and it defines the design wind speed as the 3 second gust wind speed and the number is available as 170 mile per hour. So the design wind speed is mostly coming from building codes. And if you have a site-specific wind hazard analysis, it can come from that source also. But mostly it is coming from building codes. For example, ASE 7-16 prescribes the design wind speed as the 3 second gust wind speed, and it should be recorded at a 10 meter height, and the mean recurrence interval of that speed depends on the risk category of your building. So depending upon the risk category in ASE 7-16, you first go to the hazard map corresponding to that mean recurrence interval, and then from there you pick the 3 second gust wind speed. Axis system, that information should be available to you from the wind tunnel test results that what is the axis system used, because you want to use the same axis system in your finite element model also. So for example, if your building is this and you applied wind forces in this direction and this is the x direction of the building, then the finite element model also should have the same direction as the x direction, and then the forces can be applied in that x direction. So generally the wind tunnel consultant sets the centroid of the building footprint as the axis origin, and then that information should be available to the structural designer so that you can use the same the axis for your finite element model also. Then point load calculation. We know that the floor by floor load for shear force, for example, the lateral forces in x and y direction, and the torsional moment, which is the moment about z axis, for each level I, it can be calculated by multiplying the point load coefficients with the base moment history. So that's how we transfer the base reaction history in the force balance method, calculated in the force balance method. We transfer that history to each level by using these three equations. So here, my theta, mx theta, and mz theta, they are the time history of base moments for wind direction theta, any direction, particular direction theta. And obviously, their unit will be the unit of Newton meter for basically, this will be Newton for forces and Newton meter, their units will be all moments. So these all three are the moments, time history of base moments for any particular direction theta. Because we can rotate our model to get any particular direction. So if the angle is theta, mx, my, and mz are the base moments recorded in the wind tunnel test. Now these base moments will be multiplied by their point load coefficients px, i, py, i, and pz, i to calculate the the story level forces. So Fxi is the story level force in x direction at ith level, Fyi is the story force in y direction at ith level, and Mzi is the torsional moment at ith story, which is calculated by multiplying its coefficient with the time history of the torsional moment recorded at the base. So all these three values are the load time functions. They are obviously the fluctuating time values for level I for wind direction theta. The forces will be, for example, in Newton units, and the moment will be in Newton meter units. So by this way, you can convert your base reaction time histories to the story forces time histories, and these story forces are finally applied to your FEM model. So I give you one example here from one of the sample results here, that you have all of these stories. So these are level number, and this is the height above ground and height above base. So these three are the point load coefficients. This is Pxi, this is Pyi, and this is Pzi. So these three are the point coefficients, and then point load coefficient distribution for each component. So for each x, y, and z, you will have these three columns. Then you will be having also the base moment histories, time versus mxi, mx at base, my at base, and mz at base. So time versus all three base moments are available from wind tunnel test. You now apply those three equations and convert those base moments to story forces, and then you apply these three equations, you will finally get the dynamic story forces for each story. So if you summarize it, how we can do it in ETABS now, that for example, you will have three components of base moment for 36 wind directions. So we actually rotate the model 10 degree each and repeat the experiment. So actually we have 36 wind direction for one complete cycle, complete 360 degrees. Now for each particular direction, each one of these 36 directions, we have base moment in x, base moment in y, and the base moment about z, which means the torsional moment. So basically three time histories, mx, my, and mz is available from the test results for each of the direction, and there are total 36 directions. So actually we will be having 108 time functions, 108 base time histories of base moments. Now if we want to apply this to our particular computer model, FEM model, then we first have to make load patterns. Load patterns will be actually constituted of the point load coefficients. What we will be doing, because we know that we have this computer model, for example, and we have this mx base history at the base. Let's say this is my moment at the base in x direction. Now this mx will be multiplied by the point load coefficient at each story, and this will convert those point load coefficients into dynamic forces. So which means that I can simply define one load pattern which constitutes or which contains all of those point load coefficients, and then multiply that load pattern with this mx time history, and this will become my one dynamic analysis load case. So actually what we do is that we have three components of point load coefficients. One is Pxi, Pyi, and Pzi. So we make three load patterns, one for Pxi, then Pyi, and then for Pzi. And then these three patterns are multiplied by the base moment histories, and then make the load case. So actually we should be making three load patterns, one for each of the point load coefficients. Then those load patterns will be multiplied with the base history when we make the load case in etabs. So when we make load case, we will have actually in one load case we will have three components, x, y and z. Basically these will be three load patterns which will be multiplied there in the load case with the base moment histories. So they will be simultaneously applied or they will be combined in one load case. So since we have total 36 directions, so we will be having 36 load cases for this complete dynamic analysis against wind. And 36 cases obviously will be now used in different load combinations, and those load combinations will be coming from the structural design code which the designer is using. So they will be going next in the combinations for the design against wind. So let me show you one example here. First let me show you these screenshots, and then directly go to etabs and show you directly. See, we have actually three base moments, mx time history, my time history and mz time history. We have these three base moments for 36 directions. So which means actually we have 108 functions, 108 time histories which we have to import in etabs. So here you can see an example time history being imported, mbx, which is the base moment in x direction at 0 degrees. This file is imported in etabs in the define functions, and you know already that you have to skip few header lines if they are available. This is the time step. So for this example data set, you see that the time step is in the base moment histories, the time step is 0.11 second. So we put that here. So this is how you actually import one time history. In this case, it is the base moment in x direction for 0 degree angle of attack of the wind. So you check whether the length is correct, that you have imported the correct time history. Then these base moments will be multiplied by point load coefficients when you make the load cases. So actually you have to import 108 functions at this particular step. Then you define the load patterns. In load patterns, you select the wind load type and then go for user loads, and in the user load you provide all the point load coefficients, one for x, then second for y, and then third is for z. You provide that and make one pattern. This is three times you have to perform, so three load patterns each for single direction should be defined. Now these load patterns should be multiplied by the base moment time histories when you make the load cases, and that is how you define the load case. So this is a typical dynamic analysis load case in etabs where you have selected some analysis type. I'll explain that in etabs directly, but more importantly you see here that here in one particular wind load case, which is wind direction 0 degree, you have actually imported three load patterns, which are the load patterns for point load coefficients which you have defined, and they are given with the base moment history accordingly. For example, the x direction forces will be developed or will be produced or applied in the computer model by multiplying the x direction pressure coefficients, point load coefficients, with the y direction base moment. The moment about y axis will produce the shear forces in x direction. Similarly, the moment about x axis will produce the moment about x axis is going to produce the shear forces in y direction. So for mbx you select fy, for mz you select mz. Number of output steps, the output time step if you want to increase to reduce the computational effort, and then damping. Generally for high rise building it is recommended to use 1.5 to 2.5% damping. Let me now go to etabs and show you these two options which I showed you in slides also.